Ladies and gentlemen, welcome into the Dota 2 Canada Cup Season 6 group stages. We are here. We finally got the ticket underway as well, and it is our Group B matchup between Leviathan and T-Show. We are getting ready to get into the match as we speak. In fact, we're underway into the draft, but before we get into that, I do want to say a couple of things. First of all, thank you so much for joining us here. We've had a great tournament so far. We would definitely appreciate the support. Make sure you follow us here on Mooduck TV. Check out the ticket. It's $3 in the store. It's getting cold up here in upstate New York, which is where we're broadcasting from, or at least where I'm broadcasting from. And I got to say, I'm very excited for this matchup. Leviathan has a stand-in, and you're not going to guess who it is. We're going to switch right over into the draft, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, it is none other than Jimmy Demon Ho. He'll be joining Team Leviathan against T-Show. Both teams desperately needing a win to keep themselves inside the Dota 2 Canada Cup Season 6. Today, we are joined by Pit Muckle doing the observing and producing, as always. We have mod packs and stats, as well as jokes. And then to finish it all off, it is Purge. What's up, man?
Hey, guys. How you doing? I'm pretty good at 62 degrees here in California.
Yeah, okay, whatever.
Does it make you feel better if it was 43 at 7 a.m.?
No, not really at all, no. Okay. You know how cold it was today, this morning?
No, tell me.
10 degrees. It's not even that bad, actually.
Yes, that's doable. That's like a... It's pretty darn cold, but it's not like
you still live in Wisconsin. It was cold up there, I'd imagine. So yeah, you know all about it.
I know what 10 degrees feels like. If you've been in California for like a year, going outside with a t-shirt on when it's 10 degrees feels real good. You're like, oh, I haven't felt this in a long time.
Yeah. I don't get upset at like people like you because you've been in the experience. You've dealt with the cold. You were born in the cold.
I was.
Other people, they're like, I lived in California all my life. Living in SoCal. It's been warm. I've been on the beach all my life and cold. I bet I can handle it. And I'm just like, yeah, shut up. How
Their
dare you?
Their accents don't sound like that, Mont.
I mean, I think they do.
That just sounded like a stereotypically obnoxious person to me. I don't know.
Good, because that's what I was going for. A stereotypical on the obnoxious person.
But, good job alienating all of your California viewers.
Just kidding, California bees. I love you so much. Please do not leave my channel. I actually don't go anywhere. Okay, I'm sure Charlie's actually in chat and is going to say something right now, but well, they'll deal with it. You know who's from California? Demon. That's who's from California.
That's true. So, what role do you think he's going to play? The player they're missing on their team is. Oh, wait, Shibby is there. So
Shibby's their mid.
Carry?
Jenkins, their offlaner. Yeah, they didn't carry. They played you, who was playing for them yesterday, was their carry player. I imagine Demon maybe switches things around, but they could also put him in the one role. I mean, Demon could play just about any role. That's the good thing about him.
I agree.
Like I think he's able to do pretty much whatever he wants. So.
I like their opening. The Slaughter Gyrocopter gives them a lot of options. Standard offlaner, synergizes lots of stuff. Nothing too weird to see here. And Rocket Barrage is great against Winter Wyvern as well, so they have some options there to be able to kill that.
Yeah, this is a good start, a good opening. Anything that is, let's see, Shadow Fiend has not been banned yet, surprisingly enough. And I think that should be maybe a choice for Leviathan. They might want to get it. They will have first pick coming out of these last couple of bans. However, I'm assuming it's not going to get through. There's absolutely no way that it gets through, so.
Are you sure? Sure.
I mean, I'm not, but. That's what I'm thinking.
I mean, Shadow Fiend is really good, but Gyrocopter already provides some levels of a frontline tanker. He's not as tanky, obviously, but I think SF would kind of work in Leviathan's lineup. Maybe they'd be a bit weak on disables, but we'll see. Well,
there's still a lot of stuff we could see here. I don't know. I'm just... 10 seconds. A lot of Slaughter this tournament, a lot of Alk, a little bit of Ember. No TA, actually. I don't think TA has been picked at all, so I'm okay with that. A lot of Windrunners have been picked as well. So TA is always fun to watch, in my opinion. One of the particularly good matchups, I think, for a lot of players. TA doesn't get countered by... Well, she does get countered by a lot, but she has mostly good matchups in the mid lane.
The real question is T-Show going to ban a Viper? Because Viper is generally seen as the hero that does beat TA.
Yes.
Maybe not so much in the late game, but in the early laning stage, it can be really amazing. TA is actually like that against a lot of heroes. Like, there's a couple of heroes that absolutely crush her in lane, but then after like 20, 30 minutes, TA can just go back and just two-shot him, kind of a thing. It's interesting how that hero has such a dynamic like that.
Yeah, is very interesting. I think you talked about Viper, of course, countering at the TA and beating her in lane. I think Viper does that for a lot of heroes. Like, Viper will just win them a lot of matchups. There are matchups that are not that great for him, or a little bit harder perhaps, but there's still matchups that he can win. I think Viper can win almost any matchup, assuming he doesn't get ganked four or five times. You're never really going to beat an Alk, more likely than not, because even if you do kill him a couple of times, he's still able to get back up into his full potential with his Grubel's Greed. And it's just the Acid Spray, actually, that does the most damage to a Viper, because, again, Corrosive Skin being magic resistance, the Alk's Acid Spray being physical damage. I think physical damage in general kind of counteracts the Viper, but we'll see if that is going to... They didn't ban it, so T-Show are leaving it wide open. Maybe they have a plan against Leviathan's Viper, but... They also did ban the SF. Maybe they're like, okay, let's hope they go for the SF. We could deal with that with the TA and ganking heroes. Maybe get a Spirit Breaker to charge mid. There's a lot of options. Do Leviathan go for the SF, or do they go for the Viper, or do they go for something completely different is the actual question.
And it looks like T-Show is going to focus on banning supports at the moment, so not too surprising considering that Leviathan doesn't have any yet. Bane being out of the pool is a little concerning because it is such a good hero for early roam potential and... shutting down carries in team fights, so we'll see what they open with. I feel like support picks are kind of all over the place at the moment. It just kind of depends what you want to go with. I feel like we saw a lot more variety at the Frankfurt Major with occasional like Lina supports and stuff like that, but the main thing is Winter Wyvern is still very good, Bane is still very good, and Tusk as well, another really top tier support right now.
Speaking of supports, you know what surprises me is that we don't see that much Witch Doctor anymore. I mean, he used to be like first picked. We see more Lich than we see Witch Doctor right now, as it is picked up for Leviathan. They're really just like, we don't need our mid hero yet, but still, Witch Doctor having a backseat role is kind of weird to me.
Yeah, I wonder what changed about it. He did receive a buff slash nerf to his ultimate with his Aghanim Scepter. It didn't increase the damage it dealt, but with a level 2 Death Ward, you actually do more damage than the previous Witch Doctor did without Aghs. So it's like, he kind of got better in some ways. It allowed you to build different items, but... I think people just kind of gave up on the Witch Doctor in a lot of ways. Just he's a little too squishy. And against single targets, his stun is just not good, obviously, because it only lasts for 1 second, and it does like 75 to 150 damage. You're better off going for a lot of other heroes if you're worried about tri-lane problems, usually.
Right.
So I think that's one of the reasons that he's just not played as much. He's just bad against Undyne as well. That's another thing.
Yeah, too squishy, can get run out pretty easily. His disable, especially at level 1, is not the best, and... you're not going to have the best hard disable even later on down the road. Whereas if you have Winter Wyvern, you have your Winter's Curse, which is an amazing ability. Lich is good for just being a defensive support with Sacrifice, making sure that your opposing laner does not get any extra experience.
Yeah.
I mean, even Lich, I don't really consider that great of a support, honestly. I still think like Bane and Dazzle, which have been banned out from T-Show, are better in this particular patch because they're more defensive or aggressive if you want to be the Bane and just start running around that.
Yeah. I think it's just that people are focusing a lot more on laning right now, because if you have good laning, it gives you a huge mid-game advantage, and that allows you to better take Roshan. And then with Roshan advantages, that allows you to do more things. So the laning is like the initial point of all of this, and is so important. So maybe we'll see like another nerf towards like killing Roshan, make Roshan harder to kill or something. Or maybe they'll change like the gold gain that you get from kills or from laning or something like that. I'm not sure what the solution is.
I mean, there's so many things that can be changed here. We can only even really guess at what 6.86 is going to include, but Spirit Breaker is going to be the chosen pick for T-Show, which is not really that surprising to me. And outputs, like, if you pick up a Viper or you pick up a Shadow Fiend here, he can get ganked with the Spirit Breaker and a Winter Wyvern. Both are rather good roaming supports. I mean, Spirit Breaker especially. You think about Wyvern, he throws up an Arctic Burn, and that does significant damage early. They're going to go for the Windrager instead, though. Which is okay. I definitely don't think it's the best matchup against TA, but it's not the worst. You have Windrun, Power Shot to clear the creep waves, but a lot of that damage is mitigated through the fact that she has Refraction on Templar Assassin's side. So, a little interesting to me.
I think it's okay. It's a little weird, though. Like you said, Winter Wyvern. Like, you're against a Winter Wyvern, they already have the counter to your Focus Fire and your Amp damage, but with that said, they have a great synergy combo. Like, if you just look at Leviathan's team by itself, they've got Slardar and Windranger, which are amazing together. Amp damage plus Focus Fire kills like anybody. And they have Gyro, so they have diversity and damage. It makes Gyro hit much harder.
Mm-hmm.
They've got lots of stuns. Stunning into cooldown, for example. Like, their lineup actually looks very strong as it is. So I think they're just saying, you know what, we don't care that much what heroes they have. We just have, like, the most synergistic lineup ever, so we might as well keep with what we got.
I like it a lot. If they don't get behind too far early on in the game, they could easily take it. Because they're Dire Side, obviously, they could take an easy Roche. With the Slaughter, with Focus Fire, Windrager, even without the Ags, I think they have enough damage with it. The Gyrocopter will be able to come in, throw a couple of right clicks and his Rocket Barrage and have that go to work. And they have Ice Armor too, which makes it even easier to Roshan. You know, less right click damage coming out from Roshan, which I think is fine too. Attack speed slow as well. And with Slaughter Stun, you also have a Slaughter Stun with a cooldown and Lich ult on top of that, especially if someone's Shackle Shotted. If you're Shackle Shotted, Lich ult makes it even easier on yourself. Now Tisha will grab the Juggernaut, which is a pretty okay pick here, especially against Windranger. I'm definitely not, you know, I don't dislike this pick, and this is the hero that I think we've seen the most in the tournament so far as carries are concerned. I might be wrong about that, but...
No, I think you're pretty on point with that. Maybe it's not the most popular. Jarvis maybe above him, but we've been seeing a lot of Juggernaut. Now, against the heroes he's up against, I kind of like him versus Slardar. It's very good versus Lich as well. But I guess you have to deal with Frostorm, which is kind of bad. Mm-hmm. But I think Juggernaut as a whole is all right versus the Leviathan lineup. Not amazing versus Windranger. He's like, he has this like range, right? Like he's, if he gets to initiate and it's just a solo hero, he's going to be really useful. Outside of that, he might have some trouble though, because when Frost Armor's up, he's going to be moving slower. It's going to be harder to chase. The overall Omni Slash damage is going to be a lot lower as well.
A little bit good, a little bit bad coming up for Tisha with the Juggernaut pick. They will need, I think, their offlaner, unless they want to send the Spiritbreaker as the offlane and then have an extra support come out for Tisha, which is a definite possibility. For Leviathan, they'll grab the Visage as their last pick, and now with amp damage, get a medallion on the Visage. This makes Rosh even easier. There's going to be a lot of armor reduction. Visage plus his birds will do a lot of right click. Soul Assumption is good for bursting. He does have some mana issues, but I think this should be. They have a lot of burst damage, man. Just a ton of burst damage on Leviathan's side.
Yeah, I really like Visage. I think he's in a good place balance-wise. He can break refraction charges. You can just gank with him across the map and continuously just sit your Visage in a lane farming, for example. That's always really good. So Leviathan's going to want to prioritize getting a fast level 6 on Visage if possible. Most likely they'll do, I'm guessing, Visage, Gyrocopter in the safe lane, Lich, Slaughter off lane, and Windranger mid. And hopefully the Gyro at some point can shift to the jungle and Visage can hit 6 really rapidly.
ERD will grab the Earthshaker, and he played it, I believe, in the offlane yesterday, so that might be the case this time around as well. Wow, that name.
Hopefully his Echo Slams are better than they were yesterday, because he had a really good early game Earthshaker performance, but his late game performance was mediocre.
Not great.
So,
well.
Okay, it is Demon playing Gyro.
Ah, no, I mean, that's what we thought, right? That we kind of expected that. They needed a carry. Demon could fill all the roles. It's better than switching your entire freaking roster around in terms of roles.
Yeah.
And I think that's fine.
I'd also say that putting a stand-in on a carry role is easier than putting on a support role, because if you throw it on one of your support roles, then everything gets kind of messed up in a lot of ways. Like, playing carry is pretty straightforward no matter how you're doing it. But playing support either requires a lot of communication between the supports and a lot of planning on how the game's going to go. And you might not know that if you haven't experienced playing with the teams that much.
Right, exactly. Experience is the key here. Demon will pick up an early Wraithband recipe. Before we do get into the game, guys, I want to say something real quick. First of all, thank you so much for supporting Canada Cup this season. Obviously, we have the ticket. It's in the store, $2.99. That is cheap. For all the action you're going to be seeing, $2.99 is pretty much nothing. You know what else is cheap? Our channel subscription, $4.99 to Moonduck. The emotes will be coming fast and furious. Jenkins is going to get charged up with the Arc Burn as well. It's actually very slow right now. He doesn't have Sprint. Here comes Ned at Art Stark. We'll find the Ganja King himself and body block him. There goes the usage of the Slithering Crush and Zebra's here as well. Doesn't want to skip the Frost Blast yet, but he had it at the ready if needed. And pretty good transition talking about channel subscriptions into the game. I mean, there's going to probably be a Purge face emote. There's going to be a Me face emote, I imagine, at some point. And you'll get some extra benefits as well as we get into a couple more tournaments across the season. So check it out.
Nice. I heard some echo on that one. That was good.
Yeah, that's how you know that's loud. That's like every team fight. I'm trying to figure out how to like make sure I don't clip my microphone when I go ham in team fights. I think I just have to stand way far away from my microphone. So
can they see the sword? No, it's outside of range, I think.
Yeah, it is, just barely.
They're just, I think they just maybe are happening to ping there.
Yeah, they might have noticed it getting put down. If they saw it, then they would have. I would like to see if you click on the tower, you could see the range of the tree side or whatever.
Yeah, I would like
you
that
could
too.
Do with the sentry. That's just
well, we'll see in a moment if they actually do see it. I think they don't.
No.
They would definitely go towards it now.
Eddard Stark, he's not going to go for it. Oh, he drops the sentry down. I mean, they had vision of him placing it, but they'll kill it immediately.
He was placed from the high ground. I think it was just a really good guess.
Really? That's pretty impressive, yeah. Actually, from Tisha then.
Easy gives the last hit to TA, so.
Yeah. All right.
Inflated last hits, dude.
That's important. I mean, 50 gold is 50 gold, and he's already actually leading in this lane with two lasts and a deny, and now Shibby's going to have a tough time here. And to keep in mind, also, Tisha will have a ping disadvantage, just something to keep the back of your head. Demon will be top currently. The wave is in King RD's favor, I believe. He did use the Fisher block, and then he cleared it up. I'm almost positive that's what he did, but there is a pull coming out for Leviathan and Ushim. And now we have an aggro dual lane bottom. With the Lich, it keeps it a bit more defensive. The lane will go in favor of Jenkins the majority of the time because Sacrifice will come out every 30 some odd seconds or so. 44 in this case. And Nushim going to King RD. This could be the Fisher coming up. There's no mana for the Enchant Totem. He pops the Clarity. He actually has the Enchant Totem. Nushim able to get through the trees. The Flat Cannon's going. The Enchant misses. King RD couldn't find the hit. He even thought about going. He doesn't have Rocket Barrage. He's level 2, however. On the other side, slow with the Arctic Burn and Jenkins. And we're back even. Nothing really going on.
It was overall good for Earthshaker because he messed up the pull through, and because of that, the wave's going to push, so it's going to guarantee him more farm. Nushim's going to have to do a side pull. It's the only way that he gets this lane back under control and prevents Earthshaker from getting runaway levels.
Started level 2. He's had to use all of his mana regen. He's actually only got one mango left, or rather, one tango. So that's something they should keep in mind. If they can get close to him, they can kill him pretty quickly. I got nothing to lose. Going for the bottom rune. In fact, he doesn't have anything to lose. He's going to get that bottom bottom rune, and it's going to be Zebra getting charged up by Ned. Jenkins thought about sprinting and going for a crush, but it's level 1. It's a haste rune. Uh-oh. They need to be careful.
Well, they actually went for Froststorm at level 2 here. A couple hits on Jenkins, but they are going to be slowed down.
Yeah, this Frost Armor is solid. How much armor does this give you? 3? That's pretty good early in the game. He's got 8 armor. Jenkins, that's a lot of physical damage reduction. Plus the step shield.
Yeah, the slow is far better than the armor at this stage, right. But it actually does so much if you think about it. When people are only running at like 300 movement speed, 30% is like, you run at like 220 or something like that. It's a huge slow in the early game, and it's very mana inexpensive if you think about it.
I mean, it's not like he's going to have mana issues with Sacrifice, although obviously the cooldown's a bit longer at its early levels, and you're absolutely right. I mean, you have a already slow Winter Wyvern at this point in the game. Being even slower is never a good thing. So as we continue on here, there's still 17 last hits for Demon. The wave is pushed in, and King RD is getting up to level 2, almost level 3. There's another pull coming out from Nushim, though, so he's doing his job really well. And I think at level 6, they'll rotate Demon out of that lane. They'll give the lane up to the Visage, get him to level 6. And that's what somebody like AUI with 2000 would have happen on his squad for Digital Chaos. And I think that should be what Nushim and Leviathan focus for as we get towards that level 6 in the Gyrocopter.
The last hits in this game are very weird. The top 2 CSers have 20, and the next highest is 10 on Shibby. I know it's a hard lane if you're playing Windranger versus TA, but the fact that Jug as well is also having last hit palms is kind of interesting. You usually don't see this kind of distribution in a Dota game.
I really wish that they just picked Viper, or even SF. SF could come back with stacks. There's not like there's any aggression from like the Earthshaker or the TA to put. Maybe if she got sidetrapped, she could put it in the jungle and stop them from seeing, but there's a charge bottom from Ned. Eddard Star looking for Flying Zebra. He's got the Ice Armor up. He'll get hit up. They have the Blade Fear, but get a stun coming out from Jenkins to avoid any further damage. And pretty good uses of the Slurian Crush there.
I mean, he's losing CS mid, but it's not like the fight is over or anything like that.
Oh
he
my
could
God.
Maybe get this kill.
He's going to win for one for it. King RD has his Enchant Totem. Yeah, I think he knows he's coming. He's got Power Shot in one. Can he get this off? He misses! Oh, he just needed to go down a bit more. Instead, he thought he was going to juke left into this direction.
Yeah. But he went down. It's a hard power shot to land. And he lost his rune.
Out.
And Spearbreaker finds him.
Oh, there's no... He's even got a mango, too.
He's got a Fissure. Oh, that bash is so big.
Let me get this Fissure up. Oh, they block him beautifully down. It should be in trouble. He's going to wind run towards the other direction. They do have Nushim here. He's got his level 1 Zulsumption. It's not going to do the most damage of the world, and they don't even have the stacks up yet, so... It should be actually might have to just go home here, and this is going to be an even more farm for the team who's already got 30 last hits.
On the bright side, Demon's doing really well. He's up to 35 last hits at 4.5 minutes, or almost 5 minutes. That's incredible CS.
That's pretty damn good. Got the flat cannon, shouldn't miss any further last hits here. And there's no King RD, so it's not like even with the Leaf Wish Trin, they're not letting any spirits. He's only level 3 when you think about it. What's the Slaughter's level? He's level 3 as well, and this is with the dual offlane. Of course, there is a sacrifice coming out, just to keep in mind, so they have that at their hands. And even Zebra's level 4, holy crap. They're doing really well.
Yeah, sacrifice is really good. It's one of the reasons that the CS on the Juggernaut is not very high.
Charge coming in from Ned.
It's not going to do anything.
He's not going to go any further. So that's the thing right now. I mean, you might be losing mid pretty horrifically, but bottom lane is it's not even, but they're stopping the Jug from, you know, CSing as well as Demon is. So there's maybe a slight really advantage there's actually a slight advantage for Leviathan in terms of net worth graph, but it feels like Tisho still have a lot going for them.
Yeah, it's going really well for Leviathan on the offlane here. They're also keeping pretty much three heroes busy the whole time. Obviously, they haven't been here the entire time, but they've been here a lot of the time. And Jug's farm is now going down to stacks and things like that. It's working. It's getting him some solo experience. Once he gets six, then he can maybe regain control of this lane. He needs to get a solo kill at that point or help get kills.
Jenkins is going to find an invis rune that was not scouted by the Raiding squad. Ned will look for the rune. He will not find it. He knows that there is a missing slaughter on the map now. They will have to be very careful. Getting a kill on Lovely Girl, TA's Templar, or Tisho's Templar Assassin, is going to be difficult at best. They have Refraction up. He'll try to break it, and he will actually knock it off. Shackle Shot will not land. Charge coming in. Ned was actually at the ready there. Gets a bash. Now there's going to be a Fissure coming out. Jenkins in trouble. They do have the meld. No, he's actually not skilled it. One more right click will not do the job as he sprints away, gets the salve off, and Jenkins will live. So Lovely Girl gets caught out of position, and that has really good rotations. In fact, four heroes came into that mid lane just to make sure he survived. All the meanwhile, Demon continues to farm top.
That's completely worth it for Leviathan, because Slardar used Sprint to run there, and he's got a Tranquil Boots, and all those heroes rotated. Now they get a stack out of it. They're going to stack the larger medium camps, but for a little bit of time here, Jug's going to get almost no farm, because he just can't come up with the creep wave without getting harassed. So I think that was overall very good for Leviathan. Didn't cost them much to rotate that. Flying Zebra got the experience while he's gone, and they cost TPs.
A really good lane down bottom. I like the early point in the ice armor. The 2-1-2 is enough to spam out against the Jug and deal with him because he's rather squishy early on in the game. I want to ask you something balance-wise, but I'm going to wait because I think there might be some action happening top. Maybe not.
Can't just tempt me like that. I don't care about all action.
Right. Okay, what do you think about... Because Slaughter's really good right now. The one thing about Sprint is that sure, it gives you increased damage, obviously, that it's 50% damage taken. But what do you think about giving him a mana cost? Maybe small, but a little bit of a mana cost on Sprint. Is that something to do to balance Slaughter in this game?
I guess it's one way to balance him, yeah. It's similar to how they balanced Centaur when Centaur was really popular. They just increased his mana costs by Bond Stomp by like from like 85 to like 130. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty big nerf there. And Sprint in the past did cost mana, and it did give Slaughter a lot of mana problems.
Yep.
I don't know if it's the solution. Maybe there's something better. Maybe raise cooldown of Slytherin Crush by like a second or two. Something like that might be better.
I like this Smoke of Deceit. They have the Juggernaut smoked up nearby. Demon not knowing what's going on. They're missing from the bottom area of the map. Demon still standing forward. He's got the Bracer. There's the Fissure. The Omni Slash will go. And the charge is up as well, but they have nothing to stop this. They've got the call down. Soul Assumption. It's going to go. They have no mana for the Blade Fury. And now the Rocket Barrage. Tisho's Jug going to fall. No, the Power Shot. Last right click. There's the first blood. Net in trouble. Rocket Barrage will go and secure the second kill for Demon. The turnaround. That Bracer keeps him alive. And he's on his strength treads. Demon baiting a huge fight, and they'll get the tier 1 tower on top. But mid is going to get their tier 1 tower mid traded away for that fight.
Demon seemed a little scared there. Once the fight happened, he took him like a second and a half to cooldown. Luckily, everything still worked out for them nicely because the damage potential of Tisho just wasn't there. And we can say that's Demon's itemization. Strength treads plus a bracer this early on in the game, you're mostly expecting Gyros to have things like Phase Boots, and he just has way more survivability than they expected.
Yep. Demon the tanky Gyrocopter now going to get his full drone done here. Bash. Oh my lord, Jenkins is going to get fine. Out, it looks like. Bottom
tower is under attack. He's afraid of more heroes than just one.
He's alright. That was interesting.
Lich has picked up level 6, so I would like to see him do some kind of a smoke rotation or something like that. Maybe with Slardar. Just kill anybody. Like, as soon as you get Chain Frost or a big ultimate like this, you get a kill with it, and that's what you need to do. Put it on
cooldown.
They need
to kill his TA. She's got already one Mithril Hammer. Her Desolator is not very far away. Level 2 meld.
Well, she's hard to kill with a Lich. They don't have a lot of good solutions until they have the Visage Birds. And they just got the Visage Birds. So what I would do, grab a smoke, bring Visage with his birds, or maybe just bring his birds and keep Visage top. And then do Lich Visage plus whoever is in the lane. And three heroes should be able to kill him with the dust easily.
I would hope so. However, they're going to head bottom instead for now. I don't have a smoke yet. They haven't used it. They have two of them on Zebra, by the way. And Jug's already been killed once. His farm is actually not great at all. He's got an Aquila, a PMS, and a Blades of Attack. Obviously, the mana regen from the Aquila getting some extra damage and armor going your way is great. But, I mean, he doesn't have any real beginnings of a good item. You know, so that's a big issue.
spots out the jug. He's forced to retreat. They might just turn this into a push instead. I do kind of wish that they did go for an ancient gank instead, because it's very common that TAs do go for jungling at this stage. It's kind of difficult because, as you can see, they very often put sentries down to make sure that their opponents don't see it. But with that said, just taking the tier 1 tower is also very good.
Yeah, this will make it so the jungle is a little bit easier to get into. Radiant jungle being taken control over by the Leviathan. Windranger will grab the tower kill, which she pretty heavily needed. She'll be able to buy a point booster here pretty soon, and a wand. She has the two branches, so I imagine she'll grab that too. She'll be able to be picking that up. They'll smoke up now.
It's going to be a rush, I think.
Yeah, they could definitely do it with the amplified damage, the focus fire. The
frost armor.
Yep, frost armor as well as what we talked about earlier. And even Demon coming in, if he wants to help out with this, and this will fall very quickly. There's absolutely nothing they can do about this. They can maybe try to go for a trade in the top lane, but the tier 1 tower is not even being pressured at all. In the meantime, Winter Wyvern was already warding up. So they will get a good bit of ward coverage down to the map. They'll get the TA close to her Desolator. In fact, she's got it now. But they will not get Roche.
This is really good for Leviathan in the last 2 or 3 minutes. Yeah, they got the big ancient stack, but they got so much value out of the bot lane. They got Roche immediately afterwards. And now Gyrocopter, one hero that is generally easy to burst down and prevent from farming out of control. He's got an Aegis now, so he's ready to fight, basically. He's got all the early game items, and he's got the safety of knowing that he can die twice in a fight and not get punished for it.
Mm-hmm. The biggest issue for Leviathan at this point is taking down Tisho's Templar Assassin, and she's got that Desolator. But if you get through those refraction charges, she'll be easy to kill. I mean, she'll just drop like butter. With Rocket Barrage, it makes it even easier. So that's going to be something you're going to focus on right now. There's going to be a trade, or at least an attempted trade, for the top tier 1, for the mid tier 1. And there is a Glyphite, I believe, on both sides of the map, and that is absolutely true. Lovely Girl does have the Desolator, but there's 4 heroes plus Visage Birds mid. Splinter Blast will fly, clearing up the creep wave, but there's the focus fire. Glyph goes out of the Radiant side. Dire side not using their Glyph yet. They'll finally pop it now. And even the bottom tier 1 is the Juggernaut is there. Attempting to push in. He'll be able to actually take this tower, but they will get a TP in early on. This time it is going to be from Nushim. Another TP is going to go, and that's going to be from Jenkins. And so they'll take the tier 1 tower, and they'll be able to secure both of their tier 1s, both top and bottom, at least for the time being.
That's a hard gank on the bot lane. They have to land a Shackle. It's the only way.
Looking for it. There's going to be Shackle. Doesn't actually get it. Gets kind of close. Demon can't do much about this. Takes a little bit of Blade Fury damage. Almost died to that. Not really, but still. They rotate everyone down bottom. That'll keep their bottom tier 1 alive, but this means that Lovely Girl will go top with the TA and probably take this tier 1.
I don't like Leviathan's choice there. I think instead they should have defended top.
Yeah. Well, Echo Slam's gonna go, the Enchant Totem, he'll stick up, but now the Chain Frost flies and it's gonna bounce the wrong direction. Finally go back to a couple of the heroes here, but still bounce into the creeps. It'll go into Lovely Girl again, but Refraction Charge is keeping her up and fighting. Now there's Stun coming out, 1, 2, but there's nobody nearby. They'll take the Tier 1 tower, they'll lose Jenkins in the end. Chain Frost was almost amazing if there weren't any creeps around. Oh, that would have been beautiful. But they will grab a couple of the, ooh, the one Visage Bird has been taken down. He's got the Resummon, but he's not using it yet.
I think rather than TPing bot with Visage to go defend against the Jug, he should have stayed there, because it was weird because the Slaughter TP'd top to defend it, but then Visage TP'd away from that lane to go defend a different tower. So I think they should have taken the mid tower and then tried to mass TP top or try to start a fight top, because it was clear that Tisho was there in some sense of force. They already got the tier 1 tower first. They show up, try to take a fight to Tisho, and if they can execute that correctly, then it's great for them. Yeah. But the issue is that they need Blink Dagger before they can actually start a fight in a good way. Otherwise, they have to land a Shackle.
So. I mean, they're really working on that Blink Dagger, and he's getting close, but not there yet. Sending an 1,800-ish gold at this point. So a couple hundred away. Lovely Girl, in the meantime, is going to have a Blink Dagger of his own. I'm sure that's what he's going for. The Axe isn't even done for Shibby at this point. He's close, but again, the TA is top of the net worth by a wide margin, and TA can certainly carry this game if she... gets some easy Blink, Desolator, you know, Meld Strikes. There's going to be some easy kills there.
Yeah, she can two-shot a couple people right now. Maybe Lich. Yes, yeah, he's fairly tanky. I like the Tranquil Boots and the Buckler. A lot of times you're like, oh, I'm going to make mech. I should obviously make Arcane Boots to make Guardian Greaves. But on Lich, you can't really afford to do that, I feel, because your strength gain is so bad. And especially because you're against a Jug and a TA, you need as much armor as you can get, because that's the only thing that's going to keep you from dying to simply an Omni Slash. So he's going for the full sacrifice build. And by sacrifice, I mean he's sacrificing his potential for damage and other things. Yep. He just goes max out an Ice Armor, he gets a Mechanism, he gets a Tranquil Boots, and he's going to do his best to keep his team alive. And I think that's a really good plan this game, considering that almost all of Tisho's damage is physical base.
And there's a lot of armor reduction, 8 from the meld, and the Desolator will provide 7, so that's a lot to deal with ice armor, however. That should provide them at least a little bit. And we're good to go. It looks like, well, at least Demon is saying, so Winter Wyvern has just reconnected to the game. T-Show is saying wait because internet issues, I don't know what to tell you. Hopefully we'll get... Demon, come on, man, just relax. Yeah, give him that question mark. I don't even know what that name is. And now they're speaking what I imagine is...
Why do Portuguese. I feel like Angole is something English speaker or something?
Probably. Let's look it up. It's Portuguese, by the way. Because they're Brazilian. Chupa Angole. For those of you in chat that actually know what that means, go ahead and throw it out there. Because I really want to know. I'd really like to know.
I mean, there's no way Chupa is something good, right?
No, I doubt it.
Pimp, maybe why can't you speak all languages instead of just like two? What
yeah, seriously. How's German like important at all? Come on.
I don't know if he said that on stream, but that's not PC.
Yeah, that's not PC. I mean, he didn't say it on stream. He's not going to do that. The best thing about working with Pimp is just every time I say something that annoys him and then hearing his reaction, it's great. Oh, it's beautiful.
I also get enjoyment out of being annoying to other people.
Yeah.
It's hard to grow out of that one.
Oh, it's
all right. Blink Dagger's ready to go. So Slaughter's going to be happy to initiate. This gets especially crucial because if they can do Blink stuns into call down Chain Frost, T-Show loses fights. It's that simple because that's going to limit their mobility. They won't be able to escape, and then they're going to be forced to throw out their abilities as best they can. And that's not a position you want to be in.
How about finding this TA with a Blink Dagger? Now she's got even more mobility, plus the melds. They're going to have Dust at the ready. They're going to have to make sure that she doesn't get away. They have to take down the Refraction Charges immediately. She has Refraction Charges up. She'll be able to Blink, no problem with the meld.
I think they can deal with her. I don't think TA is that scary right now, because they have such good teamfight.
Ooh, look at this. Winrich's win rate is increased by 7.1% when she's paired to Slaughter. This is out of 80
Makes
games
sense.
in this patch, so that's pretty nice.
It's not just the minus armor, it's also the stun, because then it gives her 2.5 seconds to line up a Shackle. Like, a lot of good people play Windranger, but Shackles are not the easiest thing in the world. It's a very difficult skill to use.
Definitely true. She is going to have that level 2 focus fire, plus the Aghanims within about 400 gold. Mid tower is going to get pushed by the Jug, who is building into the Battle Fury, unsurprisingly. This is the item. They'll TP back mid and try to deal with him effectively. The cooldown's going to go, it'll miss. Rock Crush will go, he'll try to TP away. They can Chain Frost this, Chain? They're going to, and they're going to keep him in place. He's not, no Blade Fury, he's got no mana and Omni Slash. And there's going to be the jump with the stun from Jenkins to secure the kill. Easy pickup coming out. TA will push top in the meantime, so they'll lose the Jug, but they almost get the tier 2 tower up there. And force out the TPs from bottom, so they keep their tier 2 bottom alive. Still, the Jug going down is definitely not what you want to see.
Yeah, they did that perfectly. They rotated just the heroes they need. Gyrocopter, because he can take an Omni Slash, no problem. He can clear the creep wave. And then they brought the Lich in as well to interrupt his TP. If any other hero was there, the only person that could have interrupted that was maybe a Bash out of Slardar, but very low chances. So easy to utilize the Chain Frost there. They even had the familiar rotate over to stun him so he couldn't get away. They played that perfectly. Great reaction.
Good rotation stops the Jug from getting towards the Battle Fury, and he is very far away. This is going to be like a 20-minute Battle Fury, maybe even later. Meanwhile, Demon's already got a full Drum Tread, Kila S and Y, about to be completed here within 100 gold or so. And Jenkins now has his Blink Heal work on his next item. The Focus Fire should be Ags upgraded now. In fact, it is, and it is level 2. He is not misskilled. He did not put 2 points into the Wind Run. Good stuff.
Demon uses his ultimate to farm and things like that, but it makes sense. He's about to go back and heal, so he wouldn't be able to participate in a team fight anyways. So, good choice there. I do kind of like his skill build, or his item build, just because Gyrocopter does get a lot of his value in the early game out of just casting his spells, and stats allow him to be more mobile. And by stats, I mean Drum and SNY, which have components of stats and mobility. The mobility really helps him do more damage with his skills, and they just generally help him stay alive. So I like this heavy stat build he's gone, even if it isn't going to be as efficient going into the next 5 to 10 minutes, because he does have almost no item slots.
So how do you build this after the items that he's picked up? Where do you go from next? What
depends how your game is going. He may have to go something like Butterfly or an armor or hybrid item, like maybe AC to deal with the TA, because that's definitely his next issue.
Yushim getting chased down. He does have some stuns on the familiar, so he'll use both of them at the same time. Oh, Ned, you've gone too far, my friend. Your head's been decapitated. People will come in with the rocket barrage, the call down, easy kill there, and you know, that's that.
Did you say Ned got decapitated? Was that a Game of Thrones stroke?
It definitely was.
Oh, sick, dude. That's awesome. Thanks. Nice job. Gyrocopter rotations are so good.
Very easy kill for Demon. He's actually, I mean, this is the reason the hero is picked so often, I think. It's just rotating, finding kills early, especially by that level 6 mark or even earlier.
Uh-oh. He's good in lane. He doesn't get punished by that much. You TP call down Rocket Barrage and all of a sudden somebody takes like 700 magic damage or something. More than that, really.
Arctic Burn. They'll get one familiar. No, not even that. It actually does go down to the creep, sadly. The other one will survive, but they don't have the resummon for 80 seconds. There's a bit too much for Nushim there, who's, by the way, very close to Axe himself after getting a medallion. He's about 800 gold away, maybe even 700 gold, so that's huge.
Yeah, this is one of those times where it's actually okay to lose your familiars. If you're about to make eggs, you're like, yeah, I was going to use that button anyways in 80 seconds, so he just has to pick it up in time, though. Oh, they can definitely deny this tower.
He's going to stack with his eggs, or with his bird, I think. That's always really nice to see. I mean, the bird will probably die because of it,
but... Yeah, it's dangerous.
It actually didn't die, and it did stack successfully, so I'll take it.
You should have slain a pretty good visage so far, I like it. I was a little apprehensive that he might not do well on it. I wasn't sure who's going to play it on the team, but he's been doing it justice. But he does play most of the micro heroes on Leviathan, normally playing heroes like Chen and stuff.
Yep. Nushim has done a great job this game. The TA is the only thing keeping Tisho in it right now. Maybe the threat of an Echo Slam from the Earthshaker or a good Fisher, maybe even a good Werner's Curse. Yurpik is certainly not doing much, and the Juggernaut is doing even less at this point, which is hard to believe. But he does almost have his Battle Fury. 21 minutes is what it's looking like here for that particular item. Sitting at almost level 12, and he's going to maybe get ganked. They know that he's up there. They saw him enter the jungle with this Observer Ward, and they're going to see him up towards that top lane. And he needs to leave right now. That's not going to happen.
Will he land the stun?
Yeah, he's down. Stun. Call down, Shackle Shot will latch, and... Actually, it doesn't, but it doesn't matter either way. The focus fire will do more than enough damage. Not sure why he decided to go for that particular push when they were all off the map, but whatever.
Yeah, that was kind of weird, actually. Maybe they're anticipating them being in Rosh at this moment because it was respawning, but... He just kind of dies. I'm seeing a lot more cracks in Tisho's lineup now, just by seeing how this game's playing out. Like, if you have an offlane Earthshaker, he needs a Blink Dagger to be really useful, right? And then your other supports are a Winter Wyvern and a Spearbreaker. Winter Wyvern isn't very good until 6, and even by 6, he doesn't do that much damage. He's more good at counter-pushing and nuking and AoEs in teamfights. So they don't have a lot of gank potential out of their lineup, basically.
No, they don't.
I feel like what has to happen is they would need to do ganks with a couple of their supports plus TA every time, or Omni Slash. Mm-hmm. And because there's so few options and it requires so many heroes, it's harder to find those pickoffs.
Well, they're going to have to try something now. They know Rosh is being taken. They have a side trap in the pit. They're ready to go. Lovely Girl does have the Blink Dagger. They see Nushim nearby and he's going to jump it with the meld. The fish will come out. They've taken Rosh already. They'll lose Nushim, but here comes the call down. Won't actually connect. Great Winner's Curse, but nobody to follow up on it. Now the meld strike goes Slither and Crush. Actually dodged it. Omni Slash will go, but it's between the two heroes. The Nether Strike. Blade Fear as well. There's the Chain Frost, but it'll bounce to everybody. King RD in trouble. About to fall. And he will. Demon standing and delivering. 4 dead on each side. Lovely Girl make it out. That was about as good as it could have gotten for Tisho. But Demon's still getting so many kills out of that.
Yeah, that was absolutely great for them. He's almost got to flat cannon as well, so Demon's going to be pretty happy with this. Ancient stack gets a good team fight, doesn't lose his Aegis either, and he just got that, so it's actually very fantastic that he didn't, because if he lost it there and the TA got away, worst case scenario for Leviathan, considering their position.
You think MKB, or not MKB, rather Butterfly is a good option? Because the TA, I mean, she might eventually build into an MKB, but right now she doesn't have that.
Yeah, he needs a way to deal with Omni Slash or TA going for him, basically. There has to be a solution, and Evasion is probably his best bet, even though TA will eventually buy an MKB. It's either that or you get something like an AC, but you don't really want to buy AC on Gyrocopter in most cases, because your right-click damage isn't really the most significant thing about your hero. I mean, you could do other stuff as well. You could go like Scotty, maybe, and just try to kite them, perhaps, and that gives you a little bit of armor and HP. A lot of HP, really, and a little bit of armor, but... I don't know. I think Butterfly into maybe an MKB is the highest right-click damage build that he could do that would help him still be competitive against Juggernaut.
He also has the Helm of the Dominator. The Satanic will be built eventually. We've seen people build it earlier rather than later. We've even seen people go like SNY Drum into Satanic. So that's not out of the question for, I think, Leviathan if they wanted to particularly interesting duel that they certainly could go for that. There's going to be a charge. They're looking for Shibby. He's got to actually jump away. The evasion will go. Now there's the call. Shackle. A great shackle shot. They need to get the rocket prize, but the Fisher came through. Now the BKB is going to get popped. They need the focus fire, but Shibby is going to die immediately. Now the Witch's Curse comes out. They have no help. Demon in trouble. He still has that Aegis. He's going to try to stand and deliver against Lovely Girl, whose BKB is now out. There's the Soul Assumption. Lovely Girl cannot afford to die, but Demon about to lose his Aegis. Omni Slash will fly through, and they'll try to tank it. There's the mech. Now they'll lose the Jug, it looks like. He's got Blade Fury. Can he get it off in time? Just barely. The Cold Embrace and the Blade Fury allowing it so that he doesn't take the Rocket Barrage damage, but there's going to be the Soul Assumption coming through. They'll take the kill as well as the Aegis down. King RD misses the Fisher. Jenkins sees it and jumps in. The Bash comes out. Now the amp damage is up, and a couple more right clicks, and King RD will fall, and Nushim will pick up the double. And again, it looks so good at the beginning of the fights for T-Show, but they just cannot complete the engagement.
Yeah, Demon played that fight really good. He just, like, screw this, I'm fighting. And he threw everything at his opponents. You know, maybe he doesn't need to get a survivability item. They do have ice armor. Because looking at him out with this ice armor, he's got like 30-some armor. He could actually just go standard gyro build. Maybe pick up MKB or something like that. He does pick up the Eagle Song, so he's still going to go for the Butterfly. Yeah. And I don't fault him for this too much. Just in case the ice armor isn't there. And it's not bad damage to have in any way. But that was a great fight for Leviathan. Everything worked out nicely. It looked really bad at the beginning, but Demon got a lot of damage out. The Windranger got crushed, which is a little bit down, a little bit bad for them. But Gyrocopter is doing so well in this game. He's farmed so amazingly. Like, he's doing, like, this is one of the better gyro performances I've seen in a while.
This is without a BKB, mind you. On the other side, the BKB has already been used twice for the Templar Assassin. The Lovely Girl needs to be very careful about how he goes about using this next particular instance of BKB or how often he uses it. There's a good gem pickup coming up for Leviathan. This game seems like it's been action-packed, but it's actually only 6-12. It's pretty nifty. It's kind of cool.
Yeah. Stats pointing out it could have been an E-Blade. It's kind of an interesting choice against Omnislash. Very good against Omnislash, but the item is kind of worthless against TA in a lot of cases. If you're trying to play carry, you need to make sure that you're attacking during the fights, and he can't take like 4 seconds out of the fight to disable him in a game where the Jug isn't doing very well. If Jug was doing much better, then you could definitely justify going for an E-Blade. So I think it's pretty straightforward. Get the Butterfly, get yourself the evasion, give yourself the 60 damage, the 60 attack speed, the extra armor. It's going to make him very, very strong in the next coming fights, and T-Show's going to have a lot of trouble dealing with him.
Don't forget Flutter, man. That's an ability.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a dumb name, but hey, it does a lot. We were trying to chase down people.
I mean, it doesn't sound cool, but...
No, it's terrible.
It's you're using a butterfly, a weapon that is... Looks like a butter... It's like a butterfly. Like,
right.
Of course it's going to sound stupid, man.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing real... What else are you going to call it, you know, with the name Butterfly? I guess Flutter is the most apt name for an ability. However, yeah. It's
I like it.
Doesn't strike fear in the hearts of your enemies, generally.
Yeah, Butterfly is not a good name for a sword if you're trying to scare people.
My sword's Butterfly. It's like you think about all the swords in the Game of Thrones universe. Needle is like maybe the worst one, and even that's pretty cool.
No, that one's like really
long
cool.
Longclaw.
Butterfly is the name for like a 8-year-old girl's sword, basically.
Right, exactly. And I mean, Arya is an 8-year-old girl to be fair, and her name is Needle.
Yeah, but she's cool though.
She's pretty awesome. First of all, we can't talk about Game of Thrones, even though I know like everyone else has watched it and read the books. We can't talk about it because there's that one person out there.
Oh, he's invisible.
He's got the invis rune. They're going to break up the smoke.
They had a dust,
but I don't
think they're
still
noticed.
Looking for the Blade Fury. The TP out will come through. They can't get the stun in time. They cannot get the Chain Frost off. If Flying Zebra had some sort of mobility item, they weren't able to stun him with the Chain Frost stun. And King RD is like, ha! Blew up your spot, and I'll TP top lane. Farm.
Yeah, that was all him. He completely saved the Jug there because who randomly has an invis? And Leviathan didn't even notice on the back lane. That's because they already saw their target. They're like, this is who I'm going for. And they stopped focusing on their own icons. Say like, oh, maybe my smoke broke. That's weird. They did have a dust, but anticipating that kind of a thing would have been difficult, I think. And either way, they're still going to get a tier 2 out of this.
Yep, that's not bad. And it's the bottom tier 2 as well. It keeps this jungle extraordinarily unsafe. Shackle shot will latch. They'll find the Wyvern. And he's going to get power shot. I think he hit his Glimmer came up. Not that it mattered. They have the gem up on, I believe, Nushim. Nushim's got the gems. They have vision easily. They're going to force out of the glyph here on the tier 3 tower. Tia is TPing back home. She's the only one that can really man fight at this point. You have only the Battle Fury on the junk. He does have Omni Slash, however, Demon. No Aegis. He still has the SMY Butterfly at the ready. Look at the Range Rex just get destroyed. Melee Rex going down to the familiars. Range Rex will fall. They might just get this up. Blank Dug coming at Demon in trouble, but he evades it. He evades the Melt Strike. Now there's going to be the call down coming out the Rocket Prize as well. Lovely Girl will fall. Jeez. A double kill. Demon freaking destroys. With Jenkins getting a beautiful dunk on it too, picks up the double. And they're going to go straight for tier 4s. They say, Jug, I don't give a damn. You can take our tier 3 tower, but we're going for this tier 4 tower in the mid lane. But here we go. Ned looking to fight. They've already bought back. There's no Echo Slam charge. Actually stops. He doesn't commit. Jug is already TP back home as well. That's going to be the end of that. Rax has been taken down. There is a dead TA somewhere in this bottom lane, and everyone else is making it out of there.
Really good push there for Leviathan, and that counter initiation stun by Jenkins made a lot of difference because it prevented the follow-up from Earthshaker. He didn't get a Fissure and he didn't get an Enchant Totem out of that. And that's some of the most important things that you can do against ES. Echo Slam obviously did a lot of damage, but if that Melt Strike would have hit and he got two more casts off on Earthshaker, you could have seen Demon die there. Yeah, but now Demon can continue going for a greedy item build, and by greedy I mean he's just buying stats. He's not saying he's not buying a BKB, and that just allows him to scale so much better against a TA and a Jug than those defensive items would.
He's going to have a Satanic, and maybe even at some point he will need a BKB. But it'll be a 10-second BKB duration. This TA has what? A 7-second BKB duration now? Whew. It's getting even worse at this point.
She does have MKB now. I don't know if she had it in the last fight or not.
She did not, I don't believe. Well, she got evaded, so...
It's possible it just did very low damage. Is that possible, or did
No, with
did
a Melt Strike like that, there's no way. I'm pretty sure it got evaded.
Okay.
I'm almost positive it missed.
Okay.
JJ said something and we didn't listen. Okay, JJ's gonna check it, so. I'm Gyro, sure it missed.
Gyro has like 40 armor at this point, so I wouldn't be too surprised that Meld striked into damage.
Oh, Lovely Girl gonna go ahead and just get out of there.
He is amped. They could turn on this, but... Yeah, that's why they're TPing, because they're like, there's a real chance that they could go on him here. Amp damage, a huge threat to TA, because once his refraction is gone, he's actually the squishiest hero ever. Normally, yep. TAs don't have to deal with that problem, but amp damage definitely provides it.
It's just negative armor. It's amp damage on. I mean, amp damage is a lot of negative armor, but still, it's just... That's what I thought.
It did get evaded, is what we're saying. Yeah. So he must have finished up the MKB while he's dead or something like that.
Well...
He can kill Windranger really easy. That's one. It was a value MKB purchase, that's for sure. Should be going for the full greed build, basically. No BKB for him either. This is why I hate buying BKB as well. Like, you're so much stronger if you just don't buy BKB.
Yeah, but sometimes you have to.
Cool. This is Demon's first Gyro game. Pretty cool. He's playing really good. Pro Gyro game, by the way.
That's still surprising. T-Show are on the receiving end of a first performance of Gyrocopter. Again, he's played it, I'm sure, in countless, you know, in-house slash other matches. Mm-hmm.
He just hasn't played core that or carry that often whenever he plays professionally. That's probably the main reason.
He's like played every other role besides carry. He's played.
I think he has played carry for a period of time with the EG with like Vitas, J.O., Bambo. I believe he might have played carry there sometimes.
Well, yeah, but... I think he might have switched.
But it might not have been during an era where Gyro was popular. Gyro kind of gets really popular for a long time and then not popular again for another time.
I can't remember, because he was in the game where they played against No Time, or not No Time, or Navi.
Camilla in the Shackle.
Oh boy, no. Ned will be able to evade it, but he doesn't have charge, and the damage is ridiculous. Shaby throws up a couple right clicks from his focus fire, they'll grab the kill. Now David's going to get his Fissure put into his face, and so... Satanic's done, 600 gold. He also has a cheese, by the way, which is pretty nifty. So he really has no fear at all at this point.
He's super farmed. This is incredible. And this is what happens when Gyro doesn't die, basically, and participates in kills and farms a lot. He's actually one of the scariest heroes late game. But it's only in circumstances like this, usually, where he doesn't get behind. And so many teams are good at ganking Gyrocopters and putting the pressure on him that he never gets to this point anymore. So
he's
going cool to
call down and anyway. Dive behind the tower. He's even going to go for the tier 4, and he's going to take it easily. Still has a Satanic, mid Rax is going to get taken down as well. There is a tier 2 tower top, so they can't actually deal with the top Rax, but Rocket Barrage will go. Good stun. Slithering Crush as well. Now Lovely Girl. Good cold embrace. They don't have the match damage. Echo Slip comes out. Should be in trouble. Omni Slash will fly. Good Winter's Curse. They might be able to turn this fight. They can't get the mech off. They've already used it. Now the Chase Frost will come out. But Lovely Girl pops the BKB. Cannot survive in time. The Blade Spin, Blade Fury Spin coming out from the junk. Not enough to keep him alive. Gets pushed back into the well, but still dies to the Rocket Barrage. And GG is called. That'll be that. And Leviathan do a great job with Demon on the, of course, Gyrocopter, absolutely obliterating most of Tisho. And the one lane that did go well, the mid lane, just wasn't enough out of them.
Yeah, that game was basically the Demon show in a lot of ways. I think Nushim played great, Jenkins played great, Shibby played okay, and Blind Zebra played very well as well. So Leviathan very clearly completely countered Tisho's strategy there. They just limit the farm of the Juggernaut, and then it became a Templar Assassin with items, but she wasn't even able to vaguely stand up to the rest of Leviathan there. So really well played by Leviathan.
With that, we will take a quick break, guys. We'll have our post-game show coming up right after here. That'll be in a minute or so. But before we do leave, I want to make sure you guys check out, of course, our channel, MoonDuckTV, twitch.tv/MoonDuckTV. Give us a follow or subscribe if you're feeling lucky. We just actually got our sub button, which is really cool. Also, we do have a Twitter. You can follow us at MoonDuckTV there as well. Again, quickly, Pitmuck will be our observer as well as producer. Mott Pax, our statsman, Purge, of course, the analyst. And my name is Mott. We'll jump to a break in just a second, guys. Stick around.